Hi, my name is Erin Crandall. I'm a master's student with Dr. Chris Rao, and I am studying the effect of temperature and selenium on larval amphibians. I'm studying two species of amphibians that are common to southern Maryland. One is the southern leopard frog, and one is the Culp's gray tree frog. Selenium is a contaminant that is commonly found in water bodies that are affected by fossil fuel combustion. And it's one of the major contaminants that stays in the tissues of the organisms once they transition from a tadpole to the adult land form. So when a tadpole changes into a frog, it's called metamorphosis. And the timing of metamorphosis and the growth that happens in the larval period leading up to metamorphosis can really impact their chances of survival as an adult. And so I'm looking at how conditions in the larval period, while they're tadpoles, affect their probability of survival as adults. After a breeding event, I went out into the field to collect egg masses and held them until they hatched into tadpoles. Once the tadpoles were big enough to handle, we brought them into the lab and separated them into different aquatic tanks, which each were exposed to different environmental conditions. Half of the tadpoles were held at temperatures reflecting current summer averages, and the other half were held at a temperature that's about 10 degrees warmer. We chose to look at these temperatures because they are within the range of temperatures predicted by current climate change models. I fed them different levels of selenium. One was a control that had no selenium in it. The second was a low dose of selenium, and the third is a high dose of selenium. Once it grows arms, I take it up to the lab and measure its length and weight and record the date. The metabolic rate that we are looking at is the amount of energy the animals are using while they're resting. We're able to measure that by looking at oxygen consumption over time. I measured their metabolic rates once as tadpoles and once during and after they turn into frogs. When animals eat food, they're converting that food into energy. The energy is used first and foremost to stay alive, and whatever is left can be used for growth or reproduction. So when an animal is exposed to a contaminant like selenium, their cost of staying alive goes up and there is less energy available for the other things such as growth and reproduction. And animals that are bigger when they turn into frogs have a better chance of survival. I'm looking at the combined effect of temperature and selenium because with climate change, animals will be exposed to warmer temperatures, which could add additional stress and alter the response to contaminants. Amphibian populations are in decline worldwide. With my research, we are hoping to learn how tadpoles will respond to selenium with climate change.